today's topic is measurement of elasticity of demand by geometric, or you can say point method, or you can say how the elasticity of demand is measured by Alfred Marshall's geometrical method or point method of measuring elasticity of demand. This topic pertains to HSC part 2. Before this, we have discussed two methods of measuring elasticity of demand. Let us have a brief reflection on them. When we are measuring elasticity of demand by Flex's proportionate or percentage method, or you can say ratio or arithmetic method, we were taking into consideration the percentage change in the quantity demand of a commodity as a result of change in its price. We were dividing the percentage change in the quantity demand of a commodity by its price to get the elasticity of demand by Flex's proportionate method. When we discussed the expenditure or outlay method of measuring elasticity of demand, in that method, unlike to that of Flex's proportionate method, we were taking into consideration the total expenditure incurred on a commodity as a result of change in its price. When the price of the commodity was changing, our focus was on the expenditure, how much the expenditure changed, or in what is the relationship between the price and the expenditure. So we were taking into consideration the change in the expenditure in price to measure the elasticity of demand by Alfred Marshall's expenditure or outlay method. Now, let us start this method. This method of measuring elasticity of demand, or geometrical or point method of measuring elasticity of demand, is used when the price changes are small. And the procedure of measuring elasticity of demand in this method is quite different from those previous two methods. In this method, we are measuring the elasticity of demand on different points, on a straight line demand curve, on a downward sloping demand curve, which slopes downwards from left to right. We are measuring the elasticity of demand on that demand curve, on this demand curve, and on different points. While measuring elasticity of demand on a linear demand curve, on a downward sloping demand curve, we are taking into consideration the fraction between the point, or you can say a specific point from which we are measuring the elasticity of demand, to the lower end of the demand curve, and it is divided by the fraction from that point to the upper end of the demand curve. So elasticity of demand by geometrical or point method is measured by dividing the lower segment of the demand curve from that point on which we are measuring the elasticity of demand by the fraction from that point to the upper end of the demand curve. See here, thus elasticity of demand is equal lower segment of the demand curve denoted by LS divided by upper segment of the demand curve denoted by US. Here we have a diagram. Two axes are here. OX means X axis. And when we are moving towards this side, it is vertical axis, or you can say Y axis. Along X axis, we are here taking the quantity demanded of the commodity. And along vertical axis or Y axis, we are taking the price. We have a straight line demand curve here. DD dash. The demand curve, a straight line downward sloping demand curve, or a linear demand curve denoted by DD dash. We have different points on this demand curve. P3, P2, P1. Or you can say P1, P2, P3. And two more points. One touching to x-axis and one touching to vertical axis. We are going to measure the elasticity of demand on the different points on a straight line demand curve. See here, we are going to discuss it. We are measuring here the elasticity of demand by dividing the lower segment of the demand curve from that point to the upper segment of the demand curve. See here, if we will go to measure the elasticity of demand from P2 first, we have to divide the difference from D dash P2 divided by the difference from DP2. And when we are going to measure the elasticity of demand at point P1, we are taking into consideration the fraction between D dash P1 divided by dp1. When we are going to measure the elasticity of demand at point P3, we are taking into consideration the fraction between D dash P3 divided by dP3. Elasticity of demand at point P3. D dash P3 divided by dP3. When the fraction from the specific point to the lower segment of the demand curve is more than the fraction from that point to the upper segment of the demand curve, elasticity of demand is greater than 1. See here, ED at point P3 is D dash P3, means the fraction from a specific point which is P3 to the lower end of the demand curve divided by the fraction from that specific point which is P3 to the upper end of the demand curve, which is D dash P3 divided by dP3. Here, D dash P3 is greater than dP3, or you can say the fraction from a specific point at which we are measuring the elasticity of demand to the lower end of the demand curve is more than the fraction from that point to the upper end of the demand curve. Elasticity of demand is said to be greater than unity or greater than 1, relatively elastic, or you can say more elastic or highly elastic. Now the second case, let us measure now the elasticity of demand at point P2. Similar procedure here, elasticity of demand at point P2, D dash P2, means the fraction from a specific point, now the specific point is P2 to the lower end of the demand curve, divided by the distance from P2 to the upper end of the demand curve, D dash P2 divided by dP2. Hence, P2 is at the center of the downward sloping demand curve. Therefore, the distance from the lower segment of the demand curve to the specific point is exactly equal from P2 to D. This is elasticity of demand is unitary elastic, or you can say moderately elastic. ED is equal to 1, or you can say it is equal to unity. Elasticity of demand at point P1 now. When we are measuring the elasticity of demand at point P1, we are again following the similar procedure. We are dividing the fraction from P1 to D dash divided by the fraction from P1 to D. This time, elasticity of demand at point P1 is equal D dash P1 divided by dP1. Since the fraction from D dash P1 is less than the distance from P1 to D, elasticity of demand is less elastic, or you can say relatively inelastic. So symbolically we are writing ED is less than 1 or less than unity. Now we have two more points. When the straight line demand curve, downward sloping demand curve, when it is touching at a point which meets to x-axis, it is touching x-axis at point D dash. Hence, the elasticity of demand at this point is 0, or you can say it is perfectly inelastic. Elasticity of demand is perfectly inelastic at a point where the demand curve touches to the x-axis. And see here, at point D, this time the demand curve is touching the vertical axis. At this point, elasticity of demand is equal to infinity, or you can say elasticity of demand is perfectly elastic. This is how elasticity of demand is measured by geometrical method, or you can say point method, or it is known as graphical method. This is all about this measurement of elasticity of demand by Alfred Marshall's geometrical method. Thank you very much.